here. So,
I'd
like to say just a few words before we do this song. I've experienced something that's been a life changer for me and for Sharon and most of my family. My fourth stroke that I had back in November of last year, it completely changed my life. And I stayed in the hospital for 2 days, and I came home real late the night that I got to come home. The next night, before I started to bed, is when I always did my Bible, daily Bible readings. I got my Bible and opened my Bible, and all of the writing was backwards in my Bible. I said, this is not right. And it stayed that way for almost a week. Every time I would open my Bible, the writing was backwards in it. And after a little over a week, I opened it one evening, and it had turned around, but I still couldn't read it. And I still can't read it. I can go through it and find some scriptures that I've known from memory, and I can go through that and keep up with it. But if it's something that I just open my Bible to a certain scripture, I can't read it. And that's different. It's changed my life in certain ways. And as you can tell now, I'm having problems sometimes speaking. But when Dr. Heddleston came back in after I had my stroke, and I told him when I got home what had happened. And I was sitting there at the house that day and just thinking about all the things that I was confused. I didn't know what was going on. And just, it came to me all of a sudden. I said, well, I wonder if I can still play my guitar. And I've been playing guitar since I was a teenager. So I went in there and got the guitar, and I started playing, and I sang songs that I had been singing since I was a teenager, and not miss a word or not miss another one. And I sat there for about 2 hours doing that. And I told Dr. Pelson when I went back to him what had happened. He said, that's from two completely different areas of your brain. And so I said, well, he said, but you can consider yourself blessed, and that's the way he put it. He said, about 90% of the people that have the stroke that you've had don't even know they're in the world anymore. He said, they don't talk, they don't communicate, they're just here, and that's it. And I said right then, I said, well, I guess the Lord still got something for me to do. He said, yeah, that's right. So that's what I've been trying to do. And I ask your continued prayers. And it's just, I don't know, it's just, when I came home from, I got to tell you this and then we'll get on to the same. When they told me I could go home from the hospital, my niece, Tori, had come by to see me. And they had already told me I was going to probably be there a couple more days. And then they came in and told me I could go home. And so she told me, she said, well, Uncle Roger, I'll just stay and take you home. And I think Sheridan's about to come back. So I called Sheridan and told her. And finally, about 8 o'clock, I guess, we got home. But it's just, you know, I mean, it has changed my life completely. I mean, it's a big change for me. Because I've always done what I wanted to do, and I've always helped other people in their time of need. But people has been real good to help me and understand. And it's just, I'm telling you, but I still need your prayers. But it's a privilege to be able to be here today with the family. And we're going to try to do a song this morning. It's been about 4 years, I think, since we did this. For the 4th of July. But it's a great song, and listen as we try to do it. If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life. And I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today. For the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away.